Android and its beauty. Without a shadow of doubt, it has the upper hand when it comes to flexibility and customizability. Its biggest rival, iOS, does not stand a chance in this one-horse race. Fortunately, you can easily modify the interface and looks of your Android device and make it suit your liking. Probably the easiest way to do so is by installing a third-party launcher. Not only custom launcher provides you with different looks, they also come with a wide range of nifty customization features and options that are rarely found in stock UIs. And that's exactly why in this video, I'm going to showcase 10 must-have Android launchers that you should definitely try. Excited? So let's get started. There is no home screen replacement on Android quite as popular as Nova Launcher. It's a staple of customization, and recently it has received its biggest update in years, courtesy of the Nova Launcher 7. But why is the update to Nova Launcher 7 such a big deal? Well, this is easily the biggest volume of changes or alteration to the launcher since Android Nougat. The biggest changes to Nova Launcher are undoubtedly in the way it feels. By that, I don't mean in your own UI, but there are a number of new settings and a good amount of these you will instantly notice if you are a veteran of the theming app. Nova couldn't be called inhabiting or lacking in options, but thanks to this complete overhaul, things may get even more in-depth as future updates arrive. Things feel much smoother and sleeker than older Nova builds. I personally wouldn't say that Nova felt slow or junky most of the time, but things also feel a lot faster in a way that is hard to quantify until you have tried the latest launcher for yourself. Talking about some changes, now it is much easier to find widgets within a brand new quick access window. Long pressing on the home screen, then swiping down will load up all the widgets. Another nifty feature is in the new search section, which has been added with the Nova Launcher 7 that allows you to add or change the default search provider when using the inbuilt Nova search widgets. You can add third-party search clients such as DuckDuckGo or even force search of Google Play Store directly. I think this is probably one of the killer additions, but it is buggy in its current state. Now, I'm not going to cover all the new features or changes in this video. For that, I'll make a separate video, so stay tuned. Next up, we have Alpha Launcher. The unique feature of the Alpha Launcher is that it takes care of your privacy. The launcher does not save your data, rather it takes permission to show your data from the internal storage. The app has a futuristic UI home screen interface where you have various customization options. You get appealing wallpaper and Alpha DIY customization that can enhance the look of your home screen. The launcher supports multiple icon pack and gestures that will help you to manage all of your stuff on the screen. Your apps get sorted into 16 predefined categories that will sort the app in an easily searchable form. Now guys, if you really like what we are doing on this channel, then we really need your support to grow. So please drop a like and comment about your favorite launcher from the list. Customized Pixel Launcher is very similar to the Pixel Launcher, and I'm sure that many of you might be familiar with the Pixel Launcher. The app is a bit superior to the Pixel Launcher and has many more customization options. Though the overall look and the theming of Customized Pixel Launcher are almost similar. Customization like interactive UI option, home screen customization, widget padding, precisely designed icon pack, fluid animation, and much more makes it better than the stock Pixel Launcher. The app has all the potential to become the best third-party launcher, and that is why we have included CPL in our list of best Android launchers. Microsoft Launcher for Android offers the user an easy way to manage their stuff on their device. Right from tailoring the calendar, to-do list, and sticky notes, the Android Launcher app makes it more productive with Cortana, which can read, unread text messages, calendar updates, and more for the user. The digital assistant is an add-on to this app launcher for Android and helps it stand out among other similar Android launchers. This app is a boon for people who have a Microsoft account because the user gets direct access to documents, calendars, and other recent activities. The Microsoft Launcher app syncs all the Windows devices and makes it easier for the user. Action Launcher has long been a favorite Android launcher of mine. It comes with a stock Android feel. However, there are some extra features that add some uniqueness. Quick Theme lets you customize the color of your UI based on your wallpaper. Shutters lets you check out an app widget without actually setting one on the home screen. It even has theming and customization elements to make your phone feel like latest Android. There is also icon pack support, frequent updates, and a lot more. There is a lot to like about this one. Even the app drawer is configurable. Block Ratio Launcher is one of the recent launchers which have arrived. It has a minimalistic design with tons of customization. The launcher is offering a new way of looking at your smartphone by giving some unique type of customization. The best part about the launcher is that it has been designed in a way to let you know about your screen time and manage it efficiently. Your home screen is divided into two sections, giving you a more profound and subtle view of your home screen. The first section consists of a drawer's home view, where you can manage and see all your applications in an organized way. The second section of this launcher consists of root view, where you can manage all your relevant widgets. In terms of customization, you can change the color of your app, drag and drop the similar app in a sorted category, and manage some other stuff of your home screen. The launcher has a simple and interactive UI with some attractive themes that makes it one of the best Android launcher right now. LaunchAir Launcher is an excellent Android launcher for fans of minimalism. It is an open source project that mimics much of the look and feel from the Pixel launcher. It features many similar features to the Pixel launcher along with a few others. Those features include icon pack support, Google Now integration, adaptive icons, and various other customizations. The original was highly touted for its stock-like appearance plus its customization features. LaunchAir is a free and open source, meaning there is no limit to the feature updates. Hyperion Launcher is the new kid on the Android launcher block. It slots in nicely between heavier launcher like Action and Nova and the stock Android experience of LaunchAir. The UI is decidedly stock looking without a ton of blot or flare. There are plenty of customization features though. They include third-party icon support, an icon shape changer, theming elements, and some other neat stuff. It supports Google Feed, but it requires a separate download just like most other launchers. It's new, but it's already slot in favorably among the best Android launcher. Smart Launcher has always been famous for its flower grid and dedicated app folder that is completely sorted. With the Smart Launcher 5, many other features have been integrated to it. This includes adaptive icons, auto color mode, and an app drawer that is highly customizable. The app drawer enhances browsing experience and smartens the both web search and the local search in the directories in the internal memory. The premium version provides advanced gesture control and pop-ups that comes with setting to modify them as per the user need. If you like customization, this could be a best Android launcher for you. OLauncher is one of the newer Android launcher apps on this list. It boosts a minimal UI, fewer than average customization, and distraction-free use. The app intentionally omits common graphical elements like icons in order to minimize the experience. You can set the wallpaper and do a few customization, but that's kind of the idea. You install it, use it, and it does not get in the way. The app is newer and the developer is still adding new features. Still, this is one of the better minimal style launcher in recent memory. So guys, these are the top 10 Android launchers that you can try right now. So which of the above mentioned launcher you like the most? Do you know of any other launcher that we should have added to this list? Do let us know your thoughts in the comments down below. And for more future videos like this, do consider subscribing and hit the bell icon so that you never miss any future videos from Extreme Droid. So this is Samir signing off, and I'll see you guys in my next one.